I want to share with you the idea of the peace path. This peace path was developed by my friend Catherine Gasper when we taught together in Salem, Massachusetts. The peace path was an actual path that we created. The students and I worked together to develop it. They would design it and decorate it. There was actually even a peace path out on the playground so that if kids had a conflict outside, they could also use the same format. So very simply, when there's a conflict between two children, let's say that I'm coloring and you steal my favorite colored crayon without asking. I would, instead of getting angry in that moment and reacting immediately, I would walk over to the sign-up sheet, the Peace Path sign-up sheet, and I would write down my name and your name. And then I would just have to let it go and just not worry about it, not argue about it, not fight about it. It would get fixed later on when we pull out the Peace Path and everyone would feel absolutely secure that the problem would be resolved. We let it go. Later in the day, after we've had a chance to cool down, maybe we've already resolved it. Oftentimes during the day, kids would go and they would like say, I'm not mad at this kid anymore. And they would cross off their name on the list. But if the conflict is still there, we would roll out the peace path. The students would sit around the peace path. And these are the steps that you would take. The child with the conflict stands on one side. The child that they're calling stands on the other. The first child says, I did not like it when you took my crayon. The other child facing that kid would say, you said you did not like it when I took your crayon. They take a step forward. The second child says, I took your crayon because I was coloring in something that needed a blue crayon and I didn't have a blue crayon and I saw that you did have a blue crayon, so I just took it. I didn't think you would mind. The first child then has to repeat that. You said you took my blue crayon because you needed a blue crayon and you didn't have one and you didn't think that I would mind. Both kids take a step forward to step three. At this point, they try to come to some realization. They have to resolve the problem. They might say, hey, you know what? It wasn't that big of a deal. It was fine, just in the future, please ask for my permission before you take my blue crayon. Or the conflict might still be brewing. At that point, they take, you can take suggestions from the crowd. So other kids in the classroom might raise their hand and they might say, hey, I think this was a case where you just forgot your manners, you just forgot to ask for permission, or maybe in the future you could ask permission before you take it, or for some kids it might just be like, hey, I really would prefer that you don't touch my stuff. And the kid might say, all right, I'll take a blue crayon from someone else. So it's a way for kids to resolve when they finally decide what the resolution is going to be. They say, we've decided that in the future I will ask your permission before I take anything that belongs to you. Or whatever it is, you know, or you've said that you would prefer that I don't touch your stuff. I won't touch your stuff anymore. And then they shake hands, or I guess now we'll do like, you know, elbow pumps or fist pumps now. And then the solution is decided and the peace path is complete. Both parties walk away. We cross their name off of the list. And that issue is resolved. And it's a very effective way for teaching kids to sort of delay their reaction when something first happens, instead of just being immediately angry or crying or sad or frightened. It gives them a chance to know that their issues and concerns will be addressed. And in because it is a step to step and they face each other and they are listening and being heard, it's a super effective way for supporting our kids in their emotional growth as they try to resolve issues in the classroom. So hope this helps, and take care.